Welcome, welcome, welcome to the last webinar of 2020. I didn't think we'd get here, but we got here. Last webinar of 2020. Super excited. Today is going to be fun. We're going to talk marketing action plan. This is a longer webinar, so bear with me today. Everyone trickling in, we're going to wait. Those of you that have been on my webinars, we're going to wait a few minutes, let everyone trickle in. Please type in the question bar or the chat, mainly the chat, where you're calling in from. I'm in Denver, Colorado today, a little overcast, snow on the ground, holiday season. Please let me know where you're calling in from. I hope everyone is safe and healthy. We're approaching the new year. We got through 2020 and we're going to talk marketing today. Marketing is a passion of mine, so I might get a little passionate today while we're speaking. And please ask questions at any time. If you have a question, if you have a comment, if you want to join in, please. Hey, I see some people from Fort Collins. That's my spot. And hello, everybody from Mesa, Arizona. I see Wisconsin, Minnesota, Oregon. Last time we often have Australia and England and always Canada. So, hey, everybody, we're going to let everyone settle in. Remember, we had over 2,000 registered for this call. So I'm going to wait a minute or two and let everyone settle in. I'm going to say thank you for while we're letting everyone come in and tell me where you're at. I'm going to say thank you to you guys because Breakthrough Broker is approaching 500,000 users. So we will hit that probably in the next month, 500,000 people using Breakthrough Broker in the real estate industry. So thank you to you guys. And we're going to get going in another about 30 seconds. Let everyone get in here, get settled. Everyone should have their marketing action plan in hand. If you don't, that's fine. Get a scratch piece of paper. This is a workshop. Okay. That means we're going to be working today. It also means it's not easy. I'm assuming most of you, if not all of you, or some of you had been on my business planning class last week. This is equally as hard. It's difficult to talk workshop and marketing and actually writing down stuff when I can't see your face. So bear with me, stay patient. We're going to get rocking and rolling here. Okay, guys, I am going to share my screen. Again, you guys should see my screen. Couple things, house cleaning. This is being recorded. I'm going to say that again. This is being recorded. You will ask invariably multiple times during this call, someone will, it's being recorded. And the reason is first and foremost, we go fast. We have a lot to cover in marketing. We could probably do a whole day workshop on marketing and we're going to try to cover this in 50 freaking minutes. Okay. So also it's being recorded. You'll get it out this afternoon. And if you don't have the marketing action plan downloaded from breakthroughbroker.com, that's fine. Grab a scratch sheet of paper and go along with me. I also need and want to thank Real Geeks. This is our first of the year sponsored webinar. We've had companies come to us and say, we love what you're doing. We want to be part of Breakthrough Broker. And Real Geeks was the first. Real Geeks came to us and said, we want to help your 500,000 users with their marketing. And so Real Geeks is the sponsor of today's webinar. And real quickly, what the heck is Real Geeks? It's an all-in-one marketing platform. And what the heck is an all-in-one marketing platform? Real Geeks has a website, a CRM, lead generation, Facebook marketing, all kinds of different marketing platforms, email, all in one. And what I like about Real Geeks is it's the most affordable in its class. You know, Breakthrough Broker, we're free. We love affordable. And so when Real Geeks came to us, I said, absolutely. I know what you guys do. I've seen what you guys do. My wife, who's a realtor here in Denver, looked at it and really loved it. So the idea here is that we appreciate the sponsorship at Breakthrough Broker. And so for all of you, you realize we're free. And so these sponsorships are awesome. So thank you, Real Geeks. There will be a link to what they are, who they are, and what they do in the recording that we get out to you this afternoon. Okay, so thank you to the Real Geeks peeps that are on this call, and we are going to keep going. Okay, guys, so thank you to them again for showing love to you guys. What is marketing? Let's get started, guys. What is marketing, and why did you even come on this call, right? We did a business plan last week. We know our numbers. So what the heck is marketing? Well, marketing is actually how you get there. So I'm going to check my chats and just make sure we're good and I don't have any tech issues here. I love that you guys put where you're calling in from. Thank you again. Q&A or chat, stay in touch with me during this conversation. So what is marketing? It's the action or business of promoting and selling products or services. Can somebody tell me what you're selling? What are you selling? Anybody? We're selling ourselves, right? So those of you that were on my call last week, this is a standalone webinar. So if you weren't on the call last week for business planning, that's fine. But if you were, you know, I tried to drive something home. If we were in person, I'd say, what do we do? What is our career? What do we do as realtors? And some of you would raise your hand and say, we find homes for people. And I would say, no, you don't. That's secondary. Zillow and Realtor.com, they're finding homes for people. You need to find people, first and foremost, who want to buy or sell a home. Plain and simple, right? So what is marketing to me and to you, to a realtor? It is finding people that want to buy and sell a home, right? So if we take this a little deeper, and I know I tried to hit on this last week, but I'm going to say it again. What, you know, if you have a GRI or CRS or Certified Negotiation Expert or CIPS, all of these designations we can get after our name as realtors or real estate professionals in this industry, all of the training we can do, all of the contract writing and everything we do to button up our contracts and our negotiation skills and our listing agreements and our buyer's agency agreements and all of those things that we always go to class for actually come secondary. Those of you broker owners on the call are probably freaking out. It does. It comes secondary. What does it matter how amazing a negotiator I am if I have no one to negotiate for? What does it matter how amazing at contracts I am if I have no one to write a contract for? It honestly doesn't matter. So the base, the core of what we do is this. The core of what we do is what we're going to talk about today, going out and finding people that want to buy or sell homes. Now, don't get me wrong. It is important and good and special for you to be a well-rounded realtor. It is really important for you to be good at contracts. And it's important for you to be good at negotiating, but it's secondary. It's just secondary. It's most important to be good at marketing ourselves. It's most important to be good at finding people that want to buy or sell homes. And if we do that, then we can be a good realtor and then we can bring the money we want to bring home to our family. So this is what we're going to talk about today. If you can't tell, I'm passionate about it. I love marketing. My team will tell you anytime we have a marketing meeting, I love it. So today is the marketing action plan. We're going to talk about the what, the who, the where, the when, the why, and the how, and the cost of finding people to buy or sell a home, finding clients, finding people to work with. Okay. Those of you that are on lots of Breakthrough Broker webinars, do you see, I don't have this microphone that keeps clicking on my sweatshirt anymore. Cause last webinar, you guys were all like, you're clicking. So I got a new microphone. It sounds better. I'm going to keep going, guys. Let's have fun with this. Okay. Because it's not easy. The next 40 minutes will not be easy. It's going to take some brain power. It's going to take some creativity, some imagination, some entrepreneurial spirit. And it's also not free. I hate to tell you this, and it's the oldest cliche in the book. It takes money to make money. So part of this marketing action plan has to be our budget. We're going to talk about budget and money and all of that stuff today. So bear with me, have fun. Let's enjoy this. Let's take a sip of coffee before we get rocking and rolling, and let's go. I believe, and you guys have seen this before, now is the time to be a badass real estate agent. For those of you that I have offended with this, I'm sorry, but this is our motto at Breakthrough Broker. And somebody sent this to me, maybe you're even on the call, a while back. They crossed out B and said, I am, but now is the time. You know, if you've been on my past webinars, that I preach that it was a difficult end of 2020, even though crazy year, everyone's like, duh, it was a difficult year in general. But it was very easy for us to sit back, right? It was easy for us in the last month or two to say there's low inventory, there's an election, there's social unrest, there's seasonal changes, there's all this stuff. And we kind of could have sat back. But I think right now is most important to actually be better than we've ever been. And so as we talk today and we brainstorm today and we discuss marketing, it's time to step up our world. It's time to step up how we do business, who we do business with, the what, the when, the where, the why, and the how, okay? And everything, you guys all know, people are calling in from Miami. I'm super jealous. For those of you on the call in Colorado today, we're in the middle of winter. All right, let's keep rock and roll. It's time to be that one realtor that our friends choose when we know 10 others. Why are we on a marketing action plan call today? Well, we just established that we have to find buyers and sellers, right? Well, also, we also know that our sphere of influence, which is generally where we get most of our business, they all know 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 other real estate professionals, right? It's just getting worse. The people we know other people in our industry. So if we're not better than them, then we have a slimmer chance of getting the business and making the money we want to make. And that's what we're going to talk about today, is being better than our competition. Last week, we did the 2021 business plan. All right. Last week, we did the 2021 business plan. And for those of you that were on that call, we came up with these numbers. All right. In our business plan, we came up with how much money we want to take home, all right, to our families. And yes, guys, the business plan is can my team put a link to last week's recording in the chat, please? Can my team put a link to last week's recording for the business plan in the chat so they have it? We'll also put this out in the email later. But last week we worked on this. I know I want to take home $125,000 to my family, and that's after I pay taxes, and that's after I pay into my brokerage, and that's after I pay my annual business fees. I want to bring home $125,000. So I figured I needed to make $230,000. And to make $230,000, to bring home $125,000, I see that I have to sell 7 million in homes, and I need 19 homes sold next year to bring home the money I want to make. Okay. And that's 15 listing appointments and 12 buyers engaged. And last week I told you, we are going to focus on this. We are going to focus on this. All right. 12 buyers engaged, 15 listing appointments. This is our laser focus all year. So we went through an hour last week of getting these two numbers. And now every morning when I wake up, I'm going to think, when I make that Facebook post, when I like and comment, when I work on my open house strategy, when I look at what we're going to talk about today, all we're looking at is how am I going to get 15 listing appointments, or that comes out to be like 1.25 a month. So I'm just going to round it up. I need 2 listing appointments a month and 1 buyer a month. Okay. That's the focus for next year. And that's our roadmap. And that's what we're going to talk about today. So it's a laser focus on the numbers. Everything I talk about from here on out has to do with 15 listing presentations and 12 buyers. That's what I need to make the money I want to make. Your numbers will be different. And this is also a workshop with a lot of brainstorming. Your marketing might be and will be different than what we're talking about today, but the general strategy is the same, okay? The general strategy is the same. So let's keep going. Marketing action plan. This can be found on breakthroughbroker.com. www.breakthroughbroker.com. Upper right-hand search tool, you type in marketing action plan and you'll find this. You can download it. You don't need it right now. You can take out a piece of scratch paper and work along with me. This is being recorded. When we're done here, you're going to have homework. When we're off this call in a half hour, you will have some work to do to finish your marketing plan so you'll get the recording. Page 3 is a little setup. For the next 5 minutes, I'm going to talk about setup. Why am I going to talk about setup and some of this touchy-feely stuff? Because you need to understand you. You need to understand why you would hire you. I want you to go home tonight and write, or go home after this call and write down on a piece of paper, why would you hire you? For the largest financial transaction of your entire life, why would you hire you? Not enough of us have done that exercise. Not enough of that have written that out and can say from the bottom of our DNA and from our gut, why we think we're the best realtors in the world. And it's funny, I saw someone on this call from Fort Collins. And those of you know that I owned a brokerage in Fort Collins, Colorado. And when Nathan and I were doing real estate, and I tried to be humble, but I want to tell you, this is how I felt. When I drove down the street in my hometown, when I was selling and I saw signs that weren't mine, I thought they were crazy. I honestly believed in my heart I should have 100% penetration into my market. I felt everyone in my town should use me. You should feel the same way about yourself. You should feel that everyone in your town would be absolutely freaking crazy to use another realtor because you're the best. And so once we have that in our DNA, it's going to come through in our marketing. So in the first part of the marketing action plan, I want you to start to look at some of the reasons. Now, we have our short-term goals. That's 2 listing presentations per month, 1 buyer per month, daily execution. And then we have some long-term goals. Of course, I want to bring home 125. I want to beat my planning goals. I actually want to bring home 20% more than that. That's my long-term goal. And maybe I want to hire an assistant or a buyer's agent by the end of 2021. So I have some long-term goals. And again, guys, you can sit and do this tonight or this afternoon when we get off, but I'm explaining why this is in here in our marketing action plan right now. Okay, guys. Now, page 5, such an important exercise. So Nathan and I had a coach when we owned our real estate business, and it wasn't a real estate coach, it was a business coach. And we loved our business coach. And she sat us down in the very first day of working with us, and she gave us this list. And she said, I want you to check every word that gives you a feeling in your stomach about. Every time, if you say the word bold and it tinges in your stomach, in your gut, in your soul, in your DNA, then you check mark that word. And we did this exercise with her. We probably felt like you feel right now. We're like, what the heck? This is lame. Why am I doing this? But we checked off bold, fearless, sincere, professional, devoted, passionate. And Nathan and I decided on some of these things together. And then she said, those words are you. You guys are bold, fearless, professional, passionate, and devoted. That is who you are. And once you know who you are, your marketing will reflect that. Okay, now we're going to talk. Guys, don't worry. For those of you who got on this call to say, I just want to know what to do next year, I promise we're going to get there. But I want you to do this after we get off. I want you to literally sit down and write this out. Why do your clients appreciate you? What do they appreciate most about you? What is my promise to my clients? I might say my clients appreciate my attention to their home buying experience. They appreciate my systems, process, and communication. You guys might ask your clients what they appreciated most about you. Not a bad exercise this week. Call your clients. Hey, I want to say happy holidays. And real quickly, I have a quick question for you. What did you appreciate most about working with me? You'll find something crazy when you do this. It's usually something that you didn't know they appreciated about you, which is great because it gives you the reason why your people love you so much. All right. I promise to deliver a remarkable home buying and selling experience from start to finish. I'm different because my experience as a police officer and detective over 13 years gives me a competitive advantage during the negotiation process of your home. So, by the way, 900 of you on the call, you may or may not know, we all had a past life. I was a police officer and detective for 13 years in Fort Collins, Colorado before I got into real estate. And I feel that's what made me so good at real estate. It was my past experience in my past life. You guys can draw upon that. You all have past lives, teachers, nurses, attorneys, all of that you can draw upon here as we write this out. Now, we're gonna keep going, okay? And then my brand message is, I'm a badass realtor, passionate about my clients' experience, sincere in my approach, hardworking, and knowledgeable. Done. That may never go anywhere. That's just my brand message to myself. This is what I think about when I'm getting ready to make a Facebook post. This is what I think about when I'm getting ready to send out a newsletter. Is this newsletter I'm sending out representative of being a badass realtor, passionate about my clients and sincere in my approach? Is it valuable? Are the people that are going to read this newsletter excited to hear what I have to say? Again, if you buy into this, then your marketing will show it, all right? So we're going to keep going. Now, let's get into the meat of this. This is the fun part. Okay. Page 8, marketing action plan. Or scratch a piece of paper. But what I'd like you to do is write down, and there's not enough room here, so you might have to open up another spreadsheet or do this somewhere else. I want you to write down every sale from 2020, and if you haven't done this before, 2019. 2019 and 2020, if this is the first time you're doing something like this, go back 2 years and write down every sale, sale price, the date you sold it, and where you got the marketing, where you got the lead from. Was it a Sphere referral? Was it a neighbor? Did you do an open house and cultivate a buyer's lead? Did you set up Facebook ads and you got a lead from a Facebook ad that you nurtured for 2 months and then they called you back to buy? Did you do buy versus rent postcard? Where did you get your business the last 2 years? I want you to write it down. Very important. Because when we're looking at what we're gonna do next year, okay, this is what we're going to look at. What worked and what didn't work. When we choose our marketing plan, what worked and what didn't work, all right? I have some questions coming in about new agents. I'm a new agent and I don't have any transactions. That's fine. You can do one of two things. You can interview a mentor, a coworker, or your broker owner. A mentor, a coworker, or your broker owner to find out what they sold the last 2 years. I think that's super interesting for you. You can look at their marketing sources and try to mirror or work on what you feel comfortable with, what worked for them. All right. Also, those of you that have been in this business for a while and have sold a lot of homes, I want you to look at what didn't work. We don't do that enough. What did you do the last 2 years that you thought was a good idea, that you spent money on, but you didn't get a return from? It's important to look at this. Again, there may not be enough room here for you to do that. Do it on a side sheet of paper. This is an important step in the process. The first step of doing all that, what am I about? What's my brand promise? Important. This is even more important to look at what worked and what didn't work for the past couple years, okay? Manny, we're gonna get into marketing cost in a few minutes. So just you guys, for anyone getting hung up on the cost there, I'll get there, okay? We're gonna get to budget and cost here in a minute. Sound good? I am moving on. Page 9, this is the part where you're gonna be a little tough love. As a realtor, as a group of people in America, real estate professionals are notoriously bad at spending money. We are notoriously bad at the old cliche, it takes money to make money. But guys, there's no business in America that doesn't spend money to make money. There's no business in America that doesn't spend money on systems, on marketing, on advertising, on rent. So you cannot be a realtor and think you could make money for free. That's your little tough love here at the moment. You cannot. You have to spend some money to make some money. So I might just say, all right, some of you may spend $10,000 a month. I'm going to say, for me, I'm going to spend $10,000 this year on marketing. Now, a good rule of thumb is 10% of your commission income. Okay, 10% of your commission income should go to marketing. Okay, so maybe you're going to spend $20,000, $30,000, $40,000 this year. I love it. You just have to understand that you're going to spend money to make money and there should be an ROI, a return on investment that's greater than what you spend. Okay, so again, I'm going to keep going. Thanks for bearing with me, everybody. Now is the fun part, the marketing channels. What are we going to do? What are we going to do to find the people that want to buy or sell homes so we can make the money we want to make to bring home to our families? That's the question. That's our laser focus. For me, I have to decide from these channels what I want to do next year. All right. For me, I have to decide from these channels how to get 15 listing presentations and 12 buyers engaged, or 2 listing presentations a month and 2 buyers a month, or 1 buyer a month. 1 buyer a month, 2 listing presentations a month. That's my focus. So when I look at this, Sphere influence marketing, okay, I need 15 and 12. I'll look at that. geographic farming or prospecting. We're going to talk about each one of these, okay? Okay. Facebook advertising, door knocking, open houses, strategic direct mail. We're going to look at alternative marketing channels. I'll explain it when I get there. Paid lead generation. That could be Facebook advertising. It could be Google ads. It could be AdWords. It could be AdWorks. It could be buying realtor.com or Zillow leads. All of that is paid lead generation in my book. For sale by owner marketing, probate, divorce, events, event marketing, like parties. It works. Trust me, Nathan, I used to do it. So let's start with sphere of influence. In my world, if I'm doing my marketing action plan, and I know my wife is on this call, which makes me even more nervous. I could speak in front of 2,000 people, but the minute she's in the class, it makes me more nervous. So let's keep going. Sphere of influence. I'm going to choose sphere of influence as one of my channels. Now, guys, you all should too. I get to speak with top producers all over the country and rookies and everyone in between. And I still hear from some of the most successful real estate agents in America that they get about an 86 to 90% of their business comes from past clients and people they know. Now, if you're a realtor that sells 100 homes a year, after 3 years, you have 300 past clients. Obviously, that's going to be a large piece to the puzzle. But for all of you, your new realtors, that's going to be your number one. That's where it's going to come from in your first year. So I'm going to talk about sphere of influence marketing. Okay. I'm going to talk about sphere of influence marketing. All right. Right here. And that's what I'm going to choose. Now I'm going to talk about the compound effect of repetitive engagement. If Daryl Turner is on this call and I can't see, we have 1,000 realtors on the call. He gave me this word repetitive engagement last week on a phone call. So I'm using it. I'm stealing it from you, Daryl. Here's your official plug on what you gave me last week. Daryl Turner, thank you. Compound effect of repetitive engagement. What the heck does that mean? That means everything you do builds on itself. The more often you're in front of your sphere of influence, the more likely you're going to be the one realtor they choose when they know 10 others. So what are we going to do? Well, we have direct mail. Let's look at direct mail. All right. So with direct mail, we can do a monthly newsletter to our sphere of influence. We can do proof of production postcards. I actually believe, I call it proof of market. So right now, I think it's really important for you to educate the people you know about how amazing the real estate market is. I think it's real important to understand that the people you know don't know real estate like you do. You wake up, you sleep, you eat, you drink real estate. They may not know there's multiple offer situations where you put a home on the market in low inventory. You put a home on the market Thursday. You have 8 offers by Friday. It's under contract at 115% of asking price by Saturday. They may not know that. So I'm going to show you proof of production postcards, what that does to educate your sphere of influence. You might send just listed, just sold postcards out to your sphere. Too many people get a new listing in a neighborhood and send the just listed postcard out to that neighborhood. We're going to talk about why that strategy is poor when we talk about geographic farming and marketing. If you get a new listing in a neighborhood that you're not strategically marketing to, then you should send that just listed or just sold postcard out to your sphere of influence, to the 300 people you know. All right. That's a strategy that I believe in. Special letter marketing. We'll talk about that here in a second. Okay. So let's look at this. You might send a direct mail newsletter. I believe newsletters are back, right? And I believe direct mail is back. When I go to my mailbox now during COVID more than ever, because I'm home and I want to see what's being sent to me. Thank God the election's over. I'm not getting any of those big election postcards, but I just want to make sure you guys understand direct mail, we believe, is back. And you could send a letter, a newsletter. Now, your sphere of influence, people you know, they open this newsletter and they read it. Is it badass? Does it have good articles? Does it have good commentary? Do you have a place in there where you can write a little something, something? Okay. So you have a newsletter. This is proof of production postcard. Okay. Proof of production postcard. Now, what you're doing, I call it proof of market now. You're educating your sphere of influence to what's going on in the world of real estate. Under contract in 3 days, received 21 offers, recently sold, and you can add 110% of asking price. This is the story you can tell by delivering direct mail to your sphere of influence via proof of production postcards. Guys, this is brainstorming here. I hope you're writing this down. You'll get the recording and you can create your own plan from this, hopefully this afternoon or this evening. Guy, somebody just asked me in the chat, yes, everything I'm showing you is available on Breakthrough Broker. I don't mean to make this a Breakthrough Broker plug or commercial. It's just what I do. So you can find what I'm showing you elsewhere. But what I'm showing you, everything is on Breakthrough Broker. Okay, guys? This is a just listed postcard. You could say now available. You could say just listed. In some markets, you could say coming soon. I know in others, you can't do coming soon marketing. You can do just sold, under contract, pending. And you can also tell a story. All right? So a lot of people are shying away from just listed postcards because things are selling so quickly. Don't shy away from that. It's part of your marketing plan. Send a just listed postcard out to your sphere and say in the notes of the postcard, already under contract, or missed out on this one already. Can you believe it? But remember, we are trying to get our sphere of influence to think we're the best realtor that they know. That's the idea, okay? That's the idea, okay? Special letter marketing. This can be marketing from the heart. We do have special letters on Breakthrough Broker where you can upload your database and we'll print, stamp, label, and mail, or you can deliver these by hand, or you can use someone else. But I like the idea of a letter where you can, the consumer can open the letter up and read something from you. These are pre-written letters on Breakthrough Broker. You can customize them, tweak them, write whatever you want. You can write a heartfelt letter. It doesn't matter. It's just part of our marketing brainstorming today. Okay, it's just part of our marketing brainstorming today. Additional sphere of influence. Remember, guys, I'm going to talk about this in a set all day. Compound effect of repetitive engagement. Email. What can we send in email? We can send a monthly newsletter. We can send a proof of production postcard. We can send coupon gifting. There's all kinds of companies out there that'll send an email or a text message to your sphere of influence once a month with a coupon or a gift from you. You pay a flat fee every month for this service. They're out there. It's great. I like Lolo, L-O-L-O, L-O-L-O, Lolo. It's a coupon gifting platform. It's not in every market. So if you can't find it in your market, I apologize, but L-O-L-O, Lolo. Special letter. You can take the special letter dialogue that we have and just send it out in your emails. Okay. There's some great email services out there. Active Pipe is one that we partner with. Active Pipe is an email platform. Again, Active Pipe. There's Happy Grasshopper. You can do email from, my wife uses MailChimp. So you can take our wording and you can go to MailChimp and create your own email newsletter. So there's all kinds of ways to engage your sphere of influence via email. So we talked about direct mail and email. Okay. And we're going to keep going. Social media. What are we going to do to our sphere of influence for social media? We're gonna have an increased presence on social media, which means something very simple. I want you to spend 10 minutes a day liking and commenting on your social media. Liking and commenting on your social media, very important, sincere liking and commenting on social media, okay? We're gonna keep going. Add value posts, I'm gonna show you what I mean. But posts where you add value to the reader. Posts where your sphere of influence sees it on your Facebook and they're like, whoa, that was good information. Proof of production. We have that same postcard as a Facebook and Instagram post. Okay. Proof of production as a Facebook and an Instagram post. Coming soon, just listed, just sold. Also on your personal social media is okay. 80-20, we say. 80% social, 20% part of your business because it's part of your life. You can post a coming soon on your personal page. I don't suggest you do a lot of it, but you can. Facebook lists, real quick. I teach this all the time. You probably all know about this, but I'm gonna tell you right now. go to your news feed on Facebook, and I'm going to speed up a little bit because we have a lot to talk about. Go to your news feed on Facebook, and in the left corner, you'll see this see more. Okay. When you click on that, you're going to see friends lists on the left side. What the heck is this? What it is it's Facebook giving you an opportunity to organize all your friends on Facebook by a list. So you can create a list, past clients. You can create a list, neighborhood friends, soccer parents, school parents, past coworkers. So you have all these lists. And when you click on that list, you're now telling Facebook, I want to see that list and what they're saying on Facebook. And then you just go like and comment. You know, I might have sold a home to Jesse, and Jesse posts an old picture of him and his daughter. And I say, Jesse, I can't believe that picture. I met you guys like 10 years after this. I wish I knew you back then. Hope everything is great. Right? You say that in a comment. Very simple. Facebook list. And I'm going fast because I got to get through all this. It's recorded. It'll be to you this afternoon. Okay, guys? I'm going to keep going. I'm going to keep going. All right? Okay. Next. Add value posts. What do I mean by that? I mean finding valuable content on the internet and reposting it for your sphere of influence to see. But it's not the content itself that's so important. It's what you say about the content that's so important. So if I found this on Keeping Current Matters and I say, rise to the top of the pool by selling your house today, it's what I say. I might type, this is a great read for anyone wondering about putting their home on the market in the near future. I've had several clients pause the home buying or selling process in the past month because of the election and because of the season. But really, choosing the right time to re-enter this market is super important. Interest rates are unbelievably low. There's tons of buyers wanting to buy homes and not a lot of homes for sale. I'm seeing multiple offer situations where homes for sale are selling at 115% of asking price. Message me if you want to discuss. It can be two paragraphs. It can be three paragraphs long. That's the gold for you. And then a good article. Okay. Again, I'm not going to read this. You guys can pause it and read it. But I found this article a while back, six reasons why this is actually the best time in years to sell a house, you know? And then I wrote why. So my sphere of influence sees me say something really smart and intelligent, hopefully, about this article. And they think, wow, that's kind of good stuff. And this is free for you guys. This is free. You can only do friends lists on your desktop, not on your phone. I just had a comment on that. You can only do friends lists on your computer, not on your mobile device. I don't know why they do that, but that's the case. Really quick hack for you guys. And I got to fly. Really quick hack. Feedly.com. It's free. F-E-E-D-L-Y. Feedly.com. It's free. You go and find all your favorite news resources. Housingwire.com. Forbes Real Estate. Keeping Current Matters. Some of my favorite. 1000Watt. Realtor.org. Daily News. All of these. Just Google real estate news. Find all these great resources. You go to your Feedly and you put it in there, and they have a mobile app. You just pop it open in the morning. You see all of your 10 or 15 articles about real estate. You find one that's amazing and you plug it in. You plug it in to your social, Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn, Twitter. Remember, I'm going to show you what this compound effect of repetitive engagement means for your sphere of influence. And I got to keep going because I have so much to talk about in like 15 minutes. Infographics. These are all on breakthroughbroker.com. I want you to leverage these for high visibility of peer value to your sphere of influence. Infographics on breakthroughbroker.com or anywhere, but infographics are great. I want you to put it in your listing presentation, but more importantly, I want to put it on your LinkedIn profile. You can write a blog. My wording is copyright restriction free. Take whatever you want. Yes, feedly.com has an app, David. Website blog. I want you to post it on your Facebook and Instagram. Okay. We have 13 of these on Breakthrough Broker. So 13 weeks in a row, you can post something to your sphere of influence in multiple parts of your social media that gives them, this is the seller's roadmap. And you can write for any of my friends thinking of buying or selling in the next month or two. It's important to know the process as it sits today. Check this out. Hope it helps. Again, remember, we just post these with a little commentary. And we're liking and commenting. I'm going to show you here in a second, right? The compound effect I want to add phone calls to this. Guys, this is really cool. And thanks to everyone for the nice comments. Patricia, Breakthrough Brokers, copyright restriction free. Anything you find on my website, you can use as your own. You can write a blog and say you wrote it. All right. So, and thanks for all the nice comments, everybody. I was able to interview 8 of the top 15 realtors during the pandemic for Breakthrough Brokers. Some of you may have been on that call. Some of you may have not. We did 2 separate titans of real estate interviews. Now, here's what we did. Here's what I found. I asked them, because now I'm not a realtor anymore. I'm like a tech guy and I love technology. And I asked them, what technology did you use most to get through the pandemic? And I was so excited. I thought they'd tell me predictive texting and analytical lists. And I was waiting patiently for this answer. And you know what all of them said? All eight said, we're just picking up the phone. We're just picking up the phone. So I want you to add this to your marketing next year. Phone calls, pick up the phone and have a meaningful conversation. I want you to do coffees and lunches. And in markets where you can't do that yet, I want you to do Zoom coffees and lunches right now. Guys, I'm calling all of my partners in the industry, and my wife can tell you, I have a Zoom coffee or a Zoom happy hour a couple of days a week. It's crazy, but I want to stay in touch. I want to have these face-to-face, and it's so important for your sphere of influence, okay? Happy hours, coffees, lunches, dinner parties, maybe next summer. But a dinner party, when we can have dinner parties, that's part of your marketing. It's part of what you're doing for your sphere of influence, okay? Client appreciation events. Nathan and I did this twice a year, and we spent a lot of money on our client appreciation events. At some point, we actually... because I was an ex-cop, I know how to get a street permit. We would actually close off the street in front of our storefront and we'd have a huge street party and we'd fly in barbecue and it was fun. And that was part of our marketing, part of our expenses. So pick up the phone, call your sphere of influence, start today, reach out and touch. It's an easy dialogue, guys. What's so great about what's happening in the world, not really what's so great, that might've been the wrong way to put it, is, but we can reach out to people we haven't talked to in a long time. Hey, as we head into a new year, the world situation has me thinking about you and I wanted to touch base, see how you're doing. That simple. Because you guys have those people that you haven't called in too long and you're like, I can't call them now. We closed it 2 years ago and I didn't do my job and stay in touch with them, right? So again, guys, pick up the phone. I got to really speed up here, guys. Now's where I show you the compound effect of repetitive engagement. Put yourself in your sphere of influence shoes. You're a person, not you. You're someone else you know. And you receive a postcard from you that's showing all these cool homes with crazy facts on it. Sold in one day with 10 offers, 110% of asking price. You know, and you think to yourself, oh, that's kind of cool. And then next week, they see you posted this thing on Facebook with a really thoughtful intro to this post on why interest rates and what it means for buyers right now. I didn't even really knew that existed. So that's so cool. And then they saw that a week or two later, you liked and commented on I took a walk with the family and took a sunset selfie. And you said, wow, the family's grown so much. I can't believe how everyone looks. Can't wait to see you guys again. Okay. And I had a really nice phone call with you a month or two ago and you invited me to a Zoom happy hour and I went, it was really cool. I had a few drinks with people I didn't know. Do you guys understand the compound effect? Do you see how it works now? You are absolutely the best realtor they know if you're doing this over time. Okay. It is absolutely this works. Right. And I need you to see this from their standpoint. So if you're sitting in their shoes and you're like, well, like I was thinking this morning, Joanna and I live in a really cool neighborhood, the neighborhood next to where I grew up. So I'm kind of back home. Right. And I love this neighborhood. It's super popular. We don't get a lot of marketing from realtors. We don't get enough. Like no one is consistently, I don't see any realtors on my Facebook feed. I don't see anyone telling me on a consistent basis how my neighborhood's doing. I know there's nothing for sale. I'd love to hear about it. So no one's really really reaching out to me about that. And that goes to geographic farming. I'm going to speed up, guys. I am going to speed up. Kathleen says I'm exhausted. Kathleen, you should be exhausted from hearing this. That's why it's recorded. And you guys can digest this slowly when you get the recording. So thank you. I take that as a compliment, Kathleen. There's a lot here and it is exhausting and it's hard. Working on this is really hard. We're going to geographic farming. I have 15 minutes to keep this within an hour. So I'm going to keep going. Geographic farming and prospecting. Guys, this is so important. Compound effect of repetitive engagement. One of the biggest problems we have as realtors is we get a listing in the southwest part of town and we do a just listed postcard because that's what we think we're supposed to do with no strategy behind it. And then we get another listing in the northeast part of town and we do a just listed postcard and maybe a just sold postcard out because that's what we're supposed to do. And then we get another one in downtown Denver and we do a just listed postcard there because that's what we're supposed to do, right? Well, throw that out the window, okay? Please don't do that. Please don't do that. I want you to have a strategy with your geographic farming, okay? You have to choose one area or neighborhood that you like and you have to farm it or prospect it for the whole year. So part of this plan, when we hang up today and you're doing this plan and you're choosing from what I just threw up on you in the last hour of what you could do for marketing, when you're choosing your marketing, I want you to think, what neighborhood do I want to conquer? What neighborhood, what zip code, what area, what apartment complex do I want to crush? And I don't care if there is a neighborhood realtor that's been selling homes for 20 years, kill them, crush them. Because you can do it if you're consistent over time in one space. So find one or two neighborhoods. The more neighborhoods you find, the more expensive it is. And we can do direct mail. Same concept as our direct mail farming to our sphere of influence. You can do a newsletter. You can do proof of production, just listed, just sold, and special letters. Direct mail is very similar. Okay. So we'll find, we have our just listed postcard, we have our same thing, we have our proof of production or proof of market. What you may not know about what we have on Breakthrough Broker is the ability for you to click on direct mail, okay, and upload your list, either your sphere of influence for your sphere marketing, or purchase a list by drawing a circle around a map, a box in this case, and print, stamp, label, and mail right out of here. The first time you purchase this list for this neighborhood, it gets saved in your Breakthrough Broker profile. So next time you go to do a postcard to this geographic farm, it'll prompt you to choose from your saved lists and you can mail this out all year long, okay? All year long, all right? Guys, there's some amazing questions in here. I'll try to get to some of them here in a minute. I like market updates, okay? We have a market update on Breakthrough Broker. We have a postcard and a social post. We have a postcard and a social post. We have these updates on Breakthrough Broker, and you can leverage these there if you'd like, but we're not plugged into data. So you have to get the data from like your MLS or your brokerage or your board of realtors has great data, and you just plug this data in and mail it out. Some more geographic farming, door knockers. And don't scoff at this, door knockers. Jonathan, yeah, we have EDDM. I love EDDM. Every door direct mail is great. We have a tutorial on Breakthrough Broker if you've never heard of it. I didn't include it in today's because there's just so much to talk about. Door knockers. I like it, especially for geographic farming, because we're talking about the compound effect. Remember what we talked about. They get a newsletter from you. They get a special letter that talks about something. They get a how's the market doing? And then you go place market updates on their door. It's okay. And so all of that stuff becomes that compound effect of repetitive engagement to your sphere of influence. And I say it again, I'm repetitively engaging you right now. Choose one area to geographic farm and be consistent over time. Be consistent over time, okay, guys? Door hangers, have them on Breakthrough Broker. Special door hangers, dreaming about a new home, let's meet for a complimentary evaluation, have them. Thinking about selling, have them. Self-promotional, have it. It's all there. All right, guys, go find it. It's usable. Don't scoff at door knocking, okay? Sometimes Nathan used to knock on the door and say, hey, I feel bad leaving this here. I wanted to hand it to you. Have an awesome day. And so it works. So I wanted to add this in here. And it's less expensive because you don't have to pay for postage and printing and all of that stuff, okay? So I'm going to keep going. Geographic farming, compound effect, social media, paid social posts, geographic area just listed, proof of production. So social media, if you're doing it for geographic farming, is more paid. And we're going to talk about that here in 1 second, okay? I'm really trying to get through a lot of this because we got to talk about budget. Compound effect of repetitive engagement. Again, this would be badass, okay? I would love to see you guys start to do webinars. Guys, we've all done a million Zooms. You've sat on my webinars. You can do what I'm doing right now with 10 slides that you create on a PowerPoint, and you can invite people to a state of your neighborhood address on Zoom. We're all comfortable on Zoom now. We're all comfortable on Zoom. I do have some people commenting door knocking with COVID. You might just leave it there. Or maybe we wait till summer. I get it. But guys, if you did a webinar for your sphere of influence or your geographic farm, you're so much better than your competition. It's funny, right? So create 10 slides about the market, get comfortable and do this. Invite them. I don't care if one person shows up. Don't be scared. If one person shows up, that's awesome. Other people saw your marketing for it. Okay, so try this, guys. I love it. I think this would be amazing. If anyone on this call, if the 1,000 realtors on this call, if anyone does this, can you share with me how it goes, please? Eric@breakthroughbroker.com. That's with a C, Eric@breakthroughbroker.com. Okay, so I'm going to keep going. Facebook advertising. This is paid strategic advertising. Now, a lot of people are frustrated with their Facebook advertising. They've tried it. Maybe you've tried Facebook ads and Facebook denied your ad, or maybe nothing. You got zero ROI because you really didn't know how to set up the audience for your Facebook advertisement, or you didn't know how to set up your lead capture system. And it can be super frustrating. So we have it on Breakthrough Broker now through our awesome partner, Walled Garden. You can find our Facebook ad campaigns on Breakthrough Broker, and it's four click. It creates the ad for you. It sets up your audience, all right? It does everything for you. It does cost money. It's $154 minimum fee for this. I have to be transparent about that, but you're using my partner's technology to get ROI on this lead. So what happens with a Facebook ad? This is the actual advertisement, and it goes out to an algorithm. It goes out to like a 15-mile radius with 50 of your new listing with 50,000 data points. People that have visited Zillow, people that have visited Redfin, people that have visited realtor.com, people that have recently bought a car or whatever that may be, whatever data my partner says that is best for you. And we might see on $154 spend, you might see 4 to 6 great leads, people that want to buy or sell a home in the next 30 days. All right. And then it's up to you to nurture those, cultivate them, and close those leads. But again, this is paid advertising. My partner is on a board with Facebook. And so these are actually instantly approved. If you use an agency or you do it yourself, sometimes it takes 24 to 48 hours to get these approved. Try it, use it if you want. It's here, or hire someone else. But either way, Facebook advertising is a viable way to go. Open houses. I love open houses. My wife makes a living on open houses. She's great. People come in. She's personable. They like her and they call her a couple days later. It's amazing. So I think open houses would be on my list of what to do for marketing, right? So market them, invite them, invite the neighborhood to a VIP open house. Again, I'm flying through this so I can finish in an hour. How about virtual open houses? We can't do open houses here right now either, but a virtual open house is kind of cool. So maybe you schedule a Zoom, you invite a large group to a Zoom, and you go through the images on a Zoom meeting, explaining about the house, talking about the neighborhood, showing the kitchen, showing the basement, showing the master bedroom. You can still do open houses for those of you that aren't allowed to do open houses right now. All right. So invite the neighborhood to, Marcella, can you take copy and paste all the comments so we can write an article or get back to people since it doesn't, we lose them. Since we lose them after we can't close this call out, because I want to address all of these comments. We have like hundreds. All right, I'm going to keep going. So in person, market them, invite the neighborhood to, if you can do open houses, to a VIP open, meaning, hey, here, I'm inviting you to an open house before the general public to see what your neighbors are selling their home for. That's a great way to get listings. Lead follow-up. This is a great thing on Breakthrough Broker that we have. It's an open house comparison chart. What I would do, I would post this on your Facebook and say, for any of my friends or family open housing this weekend, message me and I'll send you this. It'll keep you organized. And I would also hand these out at your open house instead of cards, because this kind of stuff is great for you, okay? This kind of stuff will be saved when the cards they got from 20 other open houses go in the trash. This thing sits on their counter because they can review all of the open houses that they did that day, all right? So when open housing comes back in a vengeance, this should be part of your 2021 plan. Alternative marketing channels, relocation, property management companies, divorce and probate. I teach a class titled Alternative Marketing Strategies. Keep an eye out for it, okay? Those of you that have title partners on this call, ask them for, they have this recording from last year, Alternative Marketing Strategies. We talk about how Nathan and I made a living off relocation, property management companies giving us their 60-day vacate notices so I could knock on a door and say, would you rather buy now than rent? And for right now, getting that 60-day vacate notice and saying, hey, interest rates are at an all-time low, you could probably buy for what you're spending on rent right now. Divorces, we did a lot of divorce. We call it families in transition. And mainly because I had a friend who was a divorce attorney and he helped us get to other divorce attorneys. Probate's a big thing. Wealth management, you know, they have a lot of people that come to them and say, all right, I want to diversify my portfolio. Should I buy real estate? And the first phone call should be you. So alternative marketing channels is a great way to get to those two numbers, 15 and 12. Remember, I need 15 listing presentations and 12 buyers. And I just talked for an hour about things I could do to get that, okay? Strategic direct mail. What the heck is this? There are companies out there that provide lists of most likely to sell. They're amazing. Companies like Prospect Now, Smart Zip, there's all kinds of great companies out there that have these lists. And I bet Real Geeks does too, our sponsor for today's webinar. Most likely to sell lists, okay? Most likely to sell lists. And they run these algorithms for a neighborhood that says these people have this much equity, they spend this much a year in their debt, they're likely to sell in 6 months to 18 months. Buy versus rent. I think right now renters should be buying. And then out of state sellers, market to out of state sellers, people that may not know right now they could sell their home for more money and they can get out of being a landlord. A great option, okay? A great option. I'm gonna keep going, okay? Marketing budget. This comes directly from Breakthrough Broker's print pricing. If I want to, and thank you to everyone staying for so long. This is amazing. It's been a long webinar. Each postcard mailing, if I want to send 400 postcards out, that's $360, printing and postage in their mailbox. If I want to send a newsletter out to 500 people, it's $670, printing and postage in their mailbox. If I want to do Facebook ads for 10 days, it's $154. If I want to do 100 door hangers, it's $89 every time I want to do it. I spend about $25 on a coffee meeting. I spend about $65 on a lunch, okay? I spend about, if I send 400 special letters to a geographic farm or my database, it's $576. So what I want you to do is you have to price what you decide you want to do next year. Price it out. And then you go to our budget marketing worksheet. It's right in the marketing action plan. You can download it. It's actually a fillable worksheet too. You can find on Breakthrough Broker in the Marketing Action Plan. And I want you to start putting in how much you're going to spend. And I have that $10,000 a year budget that I said in the beginning. So I'm going to look at all these overall totals. I'm going to try to get it to 10,000. Maybe I'm like, oh, it's worth it to me to go to 15,000. And I'm going to have all of these things laid out. And then I'm going to go to January in your marketing action plan. This is so great. It's so old school. You literally print it out and write on it, but it's a way to keep you guys accountable. So call 3 past clients, create a mail newsletter, coffee meeting, all these things, right? And you just do this for January, and you do it for February, and you do it for March, and you do it for April, May, June, and July. Guys, it's been 1 hour. If you love what we do and you love Breakthrough Broker, Breakthrough Plus is our community that we're building. It's called Breakthrough Plus. It's more of what we did today. It's weekly marketing discussions. It's ideas and tactics and strategies. It's designs and postcards and print and marketing and direct mail, all this stuff. And our newest feature on Breakthrough Broker called Plus. We hope you enjoy it. We hope you love it. And we hope you join us in our Plus community. I'm going to continue to thank Real Geeks. Real Geeks was the sponsor of this. You will get a link to how to have an all-in-one feature about kind of what we talked about today. They do almost everything we talked about today in one feature, all right? So that you'll have a click through to see what they do. Check them out, see if you like it. And then guys, I just hope that by being part of what we do at Breakthrough Broker, you can make more money next year. I hope that if you're able to come on a webinar or use our resource, that you can sell more homes to bring the money you want to make for your family next year. We can't wait for 2021. We have some surprises up our sleeve. We have some new tech we're building. Some of you may or may not know, we have brokerage solutions. So anyone that loves what we do, tell your broker owner they can have a Breakthrough Broker for themselves. And we're happy to have you as our partners. Thank you, everybody. This will be mailed out this afternoon. And everybody have a safe holiday season. Have a safe New Year's. And we will see you again in January. Bye, everybody. Guys, I couldn't get to the questions today. We'll do something with all these questions. Thank you so much, everybody.